I don't know how to describe an icon such as Kiran Bedi. She transcends her field of experience and expertise just as Tendulkar transcends the field of cricket and Abdul Kalam transcends the field of space science. Her name is aspirational. And I'm not saying that without evidence. I was one of the members for a selection of IAS officers in UPSC's Dholpur House. And I consistently asked every woman candidate, who's your role model? 8 times out of 10, it happened to be Kiran Bedi. I asked the same question for the selection of the chairperson of State Bank of India. Who's your role model? And it happened to be Kiran Bedi. Generations have seen her as a rebel, but also as iconoclastic, also in terms of her creative energies, building things that only she could do. More important than her fame is, I think, her commitment to causes larger than life. You know her, you've seen her on television waving flags with the current Chief Minister of Delhi in the Anna Hazare movement. You saw her doing Vipassana in Tihar Jail. You saw her taking on the establishment, taking on the Prime Minister's office and removing the crane of the Prime Minister, which earned her the acronym Kiran Bedi. You saw her in many avatars. What you also do not know is that she's an avid scholar. She actually invests a lot of time in thinking, creative writing. So I wouldn't really unnecessarily go into ends of praises, which I don't think she'd like if I do that. Instead, I'll ask her a few questions that would bring about the person in her a little bit more, and then she delivers the foundation day. Is that okay with you, ma'am? The first question is, what is your first impressions of IIM Kozhikode?
I wish I was here. I could go back in years and get admitted here to study.
Wonderful. I appreciate that. You have seen many ups and downs in your career. But I think in spite of the vicissitudes of professional life, I think there is something very core in us that does not change. So I thought I would ask you, what would be the foundational values of leadership that does not change over time? For you, what are these?
The very purpose of life. That's not changed.
Okay.
What am I here for? Why did my parents invest so much into me? Why did my teachers do it all to me? And why must I not carry on?
You know, Deepa mentioned during her inaugural speech that about your humility. Now, there's a scholar whose name is Jim Collins and who's written extensively on leadership around the world, and he's consults a lot of companies. He says the recurring theme in leadership in the corporate world is a combination of fierce resolve and humility. Just humility doesn't deliver. So fierce resolve and humility, this synthesis works. What would be your take on that?
Absolutely right. I can't improve what you said.
Yes. This is Kiran Bedi for you. All right? I don't want to hold you back for too long. So my last question is, what is that one thing, if you had a choice, what is that one thing that you'd like to be remembered for?
I would leave the choices to people.
Yes, I know. But if you had a choice. If you had a choice.
It's all about the encounters they would have had with me. If I arrested somebody, he will curse me.
Yeah,
right?
I know.
If I reformed somebody, he would bless me.
Right.
If I taught somebody, who may have remembered me.
Right.
If I made a friend who was kind to somebody, he would say thank you once in a while. Mm. I think everybody is a part of an encounter.
Right.
And why would they all remember me as a cop or all remember me as lieutenant governor? No.
Sure.
It all depends on the individual encounter.
Sure.
And the encounter has gone on now for 68 years.
Oh yes, of course. How do you, yeah, you can applaud if you want to. Well, I've extended this question a little bit more because it's getting interesting. So how do you process the enormous amount of, because if anybody reads your wiki narrative, one has to sense that it was always an uphill task. How did you find, where did the energy come to take on so many in the establishment, yet survive, not just survive, thrive? What did you do? From where does this energy come to take on, do things that are completely counter-establishment and yet get away with it?
It's very simple.
Yeah.
Every challenge comes with one more day, 24 hours. Yesterday is yesterday. Today's challenge gives you one more day, which is 24 hours of energy. Why should not be focused on resolving it?
Yeah.
So it's not the past. I've noticed everything. It may be a carry forward of what's happened yesterday, but I again have 24 hours.
Yeah.
And then if I carry it forward, I again have 24 hours of energy. I think what one must remain grateful, for which I do every morning, is the energy you have to deal with that challenge. To me, that's the challenge. Challenge is to have the energy. And the energy is sometimes gifted. It's nature gifted also. And sometimes it's engineered. So you've got to do both. They're sides of the same coin. You do not know, is it gifted today or is it engineered today? All you have to do is remain grateful for the gift you have, but work hard to earn it.
See, talking of energy, if you really want to know what Kiran Bedi eats for breakfast, it is one banana and a glass of cold cold milk, which is what food-wise is the source of energy, but there must be something very extraordinary beyond the food she has. So my final question, and I think we will have to sort of, and not just a question but a thought. You chose to commit your day here. I know you have 1,000 things to do. When you called me 2 days back saying, Devashish, are the roads motorworthy? Is this the right time? You know, this is a time of tragedy. Is it okay? I said, you know, this is the best time to be here because it also demonstrates your solidarity with the people of Kerala and your commitment to causes. And I just want to end with an expression of gratitude on behalf of the entire community, our invited guests from Kerala, very distinguished people from the media. And I want to thank her on your behalf for accepting, despite all the odds, you know, and every time she travels out of Puducherry, she has to take permission from the president's office. And she did all of that. And she said, I want to come because of you. And that was more heartening than anything I heard in the whole year. Thank you for being here. Appreciate you.
I request our chief guest, Dr. Kiran Bedi, IPS retired, Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry, to deliver our Foundation Day lecture.
What a joy. And what a privilege to be amongst all of you youngsters. I've been a fan of Professor Chatterjee for many, many years. I didn't know I will read. I was reading this author. I was seeing this author. I was hearing him. But I didn't know one day I'll come up all the way here. So you must expect the unexpected in life. Call the X factors and be prepared for it. I didn't know destiny would bring me here today. It's such a wonderful, gifted place. So I want to say how privileged you are. Do you say every morning, thank you for what, where you are? How? How do you say it? I want to know that. How do you get up? No, why should I give you a hint? How do you say great gratitude for what? Whoever did it. Somebody's invested very hard-earned money, wealth, energy into building this infrastructure for you. Out of billion and three, you're just a few. So what makes you come here? So how do you say thank you? You're a faculty. I want to know from the receiver, you are a giver. Those who are receiving it are also at their parents' cost. They're not here at their cost. They're absolutely at the parents' cost. So how do you say thank you? Life begins with gratitude. Your prayer said it all. You see, what's happened in our lifetime, in my lifetime, is loss of gratitude. And what remained and remains with me is gratitude. Every morning when you get up to say, thank you for this energy, I've got my hands intact, got my energy, I've got head right to the right place. I got my digestion system going right. Moment you begin with gratitude, you generate energy. And then your day is made. So I would say, I hope you begin. If you're applauding or recognizing whatever I've been, it's all past, by the way. I have to earn my future still. So if you're recognizing a past, then I must tell you the secret number one is every day get up to say grateful for what I have, grateful to those who brought me here, grateful to those who giving me all I have, and now is my day, what do I do with what I have? I think the moment you begin with this, you are building your whole day, and you will then monitor your day so carefully. That's been my life. It's been a watch. It's been a watch over my own self. It's a self-watch. Moment you bring in from energy, gratitude, to self-watch. And what is self-watch is nothing but personal discipline. It's not just looking at the watch. It's looking at your within yourself as to what do I do with what I have, and now what am I doing with what I have? Then comes in place all your five senses. You listen to yourself, you watch yourself, you listen to, you feel what you do extending inside, because sorry, this is not you. This is gifted to you. What you put into your stomach is a gift. Don't use, pollute it. You've no business to pollute it. It's a temple. It's a temple. So what you put here in your head, what you put in your ears, what you put in your mouth, what you touch with your hands, what you say with your mouth is exactly the expression of understanding that you are into an inherited system. It's a gifted system. This has been my second. I and my system is two separate things. And that's what's happened. It's not I and me, it's I and who. So friends, this has been my life. I hope it remains the same way. Understand that you're pretty privileged. You are on a foundation day today. When I thought over this morning that you're a foundation, this is not celebration, for this is a foundation. A foundation means, what if you were to build a building, if you were to build a building as a foundation, would you not go for the right kind of components and elements to build a strong foundation or a weak foundation? When you are being given some elements, some components, some skills, some tools, but they're not all. You cannot get all here in these 2 years. Where are the other tools coming to come from? Because that's a part of the foundation. This foundation is giving you the skills to make a great success as leaders in business, as leaders in your professions. But there are many other components which you have to learn yourself and acquire and put into your toolkit before you leave from here. Do you feel responsible for that? And have you identified? If you have, you are ready. You will build stories over stories and they will stand the test of time. But if you haven't, then your foundation will remain only one story or a ground floor or maybe first floor. Or you may have to go as become a tenant because your own foundation is gone. Remember, this is your major. This was my life. When I look back at my growing up years, and I had such visionary parents. I had the tennis ground with me to play. I had the best school to go to. I was the only one cycling around in Amritsar city to go to school because my father and mother said, you have to bike. Go biking. 15 kilometers. Go biking. If any boy teases you, slap him back. My parents taught me to protect myself. Said, go take a challenge of stamina, endurance, but saying we are behind you. That was my foundation. Did I know at the age of 10, 11, 12, why are my parents asking me, go challenge yourself and bike? I didn't know what foundation was. Today I can tell you, it was. Had I not biked those days as a girl, I wouldn't have acquired all that which still remains with me. So friends, remember, foundation has a meaning. You've called me on a foundation day. Please define your foundations. What are the components which must go into the foundation? And what is the institution giving you within these 600, 700 days? But there are many other things which you need to feed into. Are you doing it? Are you doing it in the right amount? Or are you doing 50-50? Your result will also be 50-50. If you build your foundation now, and there's not a moment to lose. The other day over a dinner, the current Director General of Police, who's in Pondicherry, happened to ask me, because I do all very funny things as Lieutenant Governor. And to me, they're the right things to do. They're funny to the others, but they're right things to do. I do weekend rounds. Every Saturday, Sunday, I take a bike, go with like-minded, go looking at city as a cleaning city, is it the city clean? And she asked me, and every Saturday, Sunday morning, 6:30, we go out and round. This comes back from the time the foundation was built. You see, when whatever you are today, if you look back, something has happened, something has built you, that's what you are. Go back and see, where does this good quality come from, or this endurance come from, or an attitude come from? It goes back to your foundation days, and foundation is absolutely in the school time or the education time. So she asked me, ma'am, I've been there as Lieutenant Governor for 2.5 years. Friends, not a weekend has gone without the morning round. On a bike or on a car, going into rural areas, urban areas, dirty ponds, clean areas, village women, SHGs, every morning I've gone. And she said, and others have not made it. And she asked me, ma'am, what gives you the stamina every Saturday, Sunday morning? I said, because Saturday, Sundays can come again, but this Saturday, Sunday as Lieutenant Governor is not forever. It's not forever. My Saturday, Sunday as self-employed will come, but as Lieutenant Governor, it will not come. Therefore, I have to give it when it must be given. So friends, that's the foundation about. Is why am I giving you this message, this example? Not as a personal glorification. A, to let you know what you've done earlier comes back now. But you have a right, you have a duty, or you have an honor, privilege, you have an opportunity to strengthen or improve it or remove it or add to it or delete it. It's up to you. But that foundation then will be the foundation when you go back to your future employment. And you get into nation building. This will become an attitude. It will become an aptitude. It will become your character. You're here for a huge character building. You're into huge foundation building. And as it said, character is foundation. As it Aristotle said, once a mother went running to Aristotle and said, Aristotle, there's a chair there. But it's reserved, perhaps for you. Aristotle said, mother went, the child saying, professor, what is the right age for me to shape this child and make the foundation of the child? And Aristotle said, how old is your child? He said, 5 years. He says, you're 5 years late. How old are you? 20, 21, 24, 23, 22, 29, what are you? 25, 23? You are 23 in time. I won't say you're late. You are 23, 24 in time because you're at the right place. So when you get up in the morning, look at your hands, saying, grateful for the energy you've given me in these hands. And now, show me the way. This is my way. Lead my way so that I remain energetic, because this day is not going to come back. No day is going to come back. For me, this day is also not going to come back. Therefore, which means every day is so precious that you give it all. And if you want to continue to build, then there is no holiday in personal building. I've run a prison. I've run a prison for thousands of prisoners. They all took a holiday one day. They all took a holiday one day. Somebody committed a crime. Somebody murdered. Somebody committed a shot or gun one day. And there were some of them were 40 years old, some were 35 years old. They did it only one day, and they were there for life. So in friends, for the right things in life, there is no holiday. But doing the right thing is a holiday, because it gives you so much of joy. In the end, when you have a holiday, what do you do have a holiday for? To have fun, to enjoy, to get a sense of achievement, to be happy, right? So doing the right thing gives you happiness, isn't it? You're on a holiday. Then the second question she asked me, we were all on a dinner. And as I said, it was a round.